الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله مده تعالى واستعين به واستغفره واستهديه، وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. وستيل this beautiful and the great journey of the Holy Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all amongst those who are reading the Quran al-Kareem and getting its barakah and the blessings and the rahmah and forgiveness. And those who are following the Quran al-Kareem and those who will be inshallah in Jannah because of the intercession of the Holy Quran, Ya Rabbil Alameen. We're still in the Surah Al-A'raf, the chapter of the Heights. Let us cover this subject tonight regarding the people of the Sabbath, which is the followers of Musa alayhi salam also. We're still mentioning their problems the way the Quran al-Kareem mentioned it. Verse 163-166, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us about the people of the Sabbath, Ahlul Sabt. Sabbath means Sabt, Saturday. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاسْأَلْهُمْ عَنِ الْقَرْيَةِ الَّتِي كَانَتْ حَاضِرَةَ الْبَحْرِ إذ يعدون في السبت إذ تأتيهم حيتانهم يوم سبتهم شرعا ويوم لا يسبتون لا تأتيهم كذلك نبلوهم بما كانوا يفسقون. وإذ قالت أمة منهم لما تعظون قوما الله مهلكهم أو معذبهم عذابا شديدا قالوا معذرة إلى ربكم ولعلهم يتقون. فلما نسوا ما ذكروا به أنجينا الذين ينهون عن السوء وأخذنا الذين ظلموا بعذاب بئيس بما كانوا يفسقون. فلما عتوا عما نهوا عنه قلنا لهم كونوا قردة خاسئين. الله أكبر. Look at these آيات. الله سبحانه وتعالى is telling us something happened. And he's talking about the punishment of the children of Israel for the matter of the Sabbath and their evil deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ask them, who? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ask them, O Muhammad, about the city that was by the sea. What kind of city? They said Tabariya, could be. They said Madian. Madian, it's the city of Shu'aib, Prophet Shu'aib. And they said Aylah or Eilat now. And the most of the scholars, they said it's Eilat. Because Eilat, Hadrat al-Bahr, it's close to the ocean. To the, they call it now, it's Al-Aqaba Gulf. Eilat. And Eilat, close to al-Bahr Mutawassit too. The Mediterranean Sea. And said, ask them, O Muhammad, about the city that was by the sea. When they transgressed in the matter of the Sabbath, Saturday, when their fish came to them openly on the Sabbath day and did not come to them on the day they had no Sabbath. Yeah, the rest of the days. Yeah, just the fish comes Saturday, yeah, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, there is no fish at all. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala examined them. It's ikhtibar from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Examined them. Why? Because they were transgressors. فالله سبحانه وتعالى make it a test for them. In this way, we put them to a test because they used to disobey Allah. When a group among them said, why do you advise people whom Allah is about to destroy or to punish with a severe punishment? The advisors, al-wa'idhun, said, to be excused before Allah. Yani, these people, they were three groups. One group, they were the advisors. They were good. Second group, they were quiet. And they told them, why you are advising them while Allah is going to punish them, the second group. The third group, those who make al-mukhalafah and they disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they fish during the Sabbath. And perhaps they may fear Allah. They said that. The advisors, they said, to be excused for us and before Allah, and perhaps maybe they will fear Allah. So when they forgot the advice that they were given, the bad ones, we saved those whom had forbidden evil and seized those whom did wrong with a severe punishment because they used to disobey Allah. So when they exceeded the limits of what they were forbidden from, we said to them, be you monkeys, despised and rejected. I have a note here in Tafsir Nur al-Bayan that just happened to the people of that city, Eilat, not for all of the children of Israel, and it is a severe warning to the mankind that they should not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they should not disobey what Allah commands them to do, and to be far away from what He prohibits them. Now we can understand this ayat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, was'alhum. Was'alhum means ask. Is'al means ask them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because Rasulullah, he did not learn from any teacher. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he learned directly from, he never read any book. And he did not learn from any teacher. He learned directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not know anything except whatever Allah is telling him. He's muballigh. He's delivering the message. That's why he said, go ask them, was'alhum. Was'alhum an al-qariya. What is al-qariya? Eilat. Tabariya or Madian, but here Eilat. يعني يا رسول الله or رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, go ask the people of the book about this village. This village, who told رسول الله? Jibreel, Quran. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم was not there during that time, عليه الصلاة والسلام. That's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى, into many ayat, He was telling Rasulullah, وَمَا كُنْتَ وَمَا كُنْتَ وَمَا كُنْتَ وَمَا كُنْتَ. He was not there. For example, he said, وَمَا كُنْتَ بِجَانِبِ الْغَرْبِيِّ إِذْ قَضَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَى الْأَجْلِ. He was not there beside الغربي, the mountain of Tur, when we talked to Musa. He was not there, Ya Muhammad, but we mentioned that to you in the Quran. He said, وَمَا كُنْتَ لَدَيْهِمْ إِذْ يُلْقُونَ أَقْلَامَهُمْ أَيُّهُمْ يَكْفُلُ مَرْيَمْ. He was not there when they were, subhanAllah, drawing to who gonna take care of Maryam. He was not there, but I told you in the Quran, Ya Rasulullah. وَمَا كُنْتَ تَتْلُو مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَلَا تَخُطُّهُ بِيَمِينِكَ إِذَا لَارْتَابَ الْمُبْطِلُونَ. You never read any book or you never write any book before the Quran, Ya Muhammad. Then if you write and you read, those who are in doubt, they're gonna put people in doubt about Islam. See, means Rasulullah was not there. Even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was in his two journeys, Al-Isra and Al-Mi'raj, when he came back, he was sitting in Al-Hijr around the Kaaba. Hajr Ismail, it's a part of the Kaaba. And they asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, can you describe the Masjid al-Aqsa, Masjid al-Aqsa to us? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not have camera and he did not even remember. But Allah with him all the time supported him. Allah raised the Masjid al-Aqsa front of his eyes. And they said, look at this window, look at this side, look at this door. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was describing everything to them. They said, yes, this is what happened. And Allah said, was'al man arsalna qablaka min rusulina. Ask Ya Muhammad, those who came before us from amongst our messengers and the Prophet. How are Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam going to ask them? Already he met them in Al-Mi'raj, right? And he was the Imam. And he saw each one of them and he was talking to each one of them. That's why I'm sure he was asking them about everything. Yes, that's why Allah said, was'al, ask. Man arsalna, whom we send before you from amongst our messengers and the Prophets. These people, إذ يعدون في السبت إذ تأتيهم حيتانهم يوم سبتهم شرعا. الحيتان جمع حوت. الحوت means the fish. It's a fish. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى, because of their transgression and because of their disobedience to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, these people, Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, okay, there is a day you have to cut yourself off from any kind of work and what? Worship me. What that day? The day of what? Sabbath, Saturday. Why Allah make it difficult for them? Because they disobeyed Allah a lot. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them that kind of punishment. The day of Sabbath, you're not allowed to put fire. You're not allowed to cook. You're not allowed to do anything. To fish, to work. That's why just stay, make ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the fitna, the test, how? During they used to live beside the ocean. They were in Eilat. Huh? These people, all the week there is no fish. Even one fish is not coming to them. But only Saturday they see all the fish of the ocean comes front of them like blowing like this. This is a fitna now. What? Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, there's no fish. And all fish disappeared. Only the fish comes Saturday. This is a test. What they did, Kharbani. Friday night, they get the net and they put it somehow and they take it Sunday. Oh, خلاص. We're not fishing Saturday. And طبعاً, the fish will go to the net during the time and they just and first people they create the net, these people. Nobody make this net before for the fishing. Subhanallah. Somehow they try to deceive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you see too many people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, why Allah make it difficult for them? He said, فَبُظُلْمٍ مِنَ الَّذِينَ هَادُ, because of their transgression. They were unjust. فَبُظُلْمٍ, because of their zulm. حَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ طَيِّبَاتٍ أُحِلَّتْ لَهُمْ. We forbidden too many halal things for them. خلاص, it's not for you anymore. Why? Because they were bad. They were bad. For example, you see somebody, يعني, is doing haram, and he's getting most of his money from haram. Like for example, somebody murtashi, the bribery. Somebody bribery, yani murtashi. Maybe he can get thousands, millions of dollars or whatever money, but somehow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open too many doors of him from calamities, problems, sickness. Somehow his money will go to like a hole. It will go to that way. See? فالله سبحانه وتعالى don't think الله سبحانه وتعالى gonna leave it like that. إن ربك لبالمرصاد. If somebody make anything حرام like the people of فرعون or عاد and ثمود according to this آيات, ألم ترى كيف فعل ربك بعاد كذا, ها, وفرعون ذي الأوتاد الذين طغوا في البلاد فأكثروا فيها الفساد فصب عليهم ربك سوط عذاب. Allah did punish them, فرعون, عاد, ثمود, because of their transgression. And Allah said, did he leave it like that? No. After that, he said, إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَبِالْمِرْصَادِ, means anybody gonna do like them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala standing for them. Ha, the punishment is waiting for them. The same thing, this people, the people of the Sabbath. Everything was halal, easy. But because of their transgression, they disobedient, they became disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah make it haram, difficult for them. And also, subhanallah, they twisted everything. See too many Muslims nowadays, somebody's going to say Jum'ah. Say Jum'ah, I have a question for you. Say Jum'ah, he's coming to ask the question in certain way. He need from say Jum'ah the answer to be fitting his mind, like a good fit for him. He twisted the question to get the answer be twisted too. This is what he want. He need fatwa متفصلة على علي. Fatwa يعني is matching with his desire and his mind. See, he doesn't like my say Jum'ah. He will look for another sheikh. He can make it easy for him and give him that fatwa. See? But these people, they are with Nekfen, Yaguha, where is your ears, Yaguha? Where is your ears? He can say like this. He said, La, it's not here. Allah. See, too many people, they are twisting the deen. They need deen متفصل, fitting their desires and their mind. Ayo. فسبحانallah, يعني عايزين دين يطول ويقصر على الرقبة, حبة بحبة. أيوة, وأمان يا للي, هم ده اللي عايزين. عايزين دين أمان يا للي. أيوة بالظبط. فهم بني إسرائيل, the people of the Sabbath. They put the net Friday night, they get it Sunday. أهو, we are not fishing Saturday. يا راجل. They think they deceive Allah سبحانه وتعالى. See? فذات سوى الله سبحانه وتعالى. يعني really, he put them in big problem. Big problem. What happened to them? See this, the people of the Sabbath. وَإِذْ قَالَتْ أُمَّةٌ مِّنْهُمْ لِمَ تَعِذُونَ قَوْمًا. These people, they became three groups. The advisors, second group, those أُمَّةٌ مِّنْهُمْ لِمَ تَعِذُونَ قَوْمًا. They told the advisors, why you are advising these people and Allah already gonna punish them. They are kharmanin. Forget them. And this is what they said. They were quiet. The third group, those who were fishing on the Saturday. And when they became like this, subhanallah, the advisor, they said, they answered these people, those who said, don't advise them, forget them, like that. And those advisors, al-wa'idhun, they said, ma'adhiratan ila rabbikum. We're going to have an excuse with Allah. They will have to do our job. And we are against this, we have to speak out loud. And if Allah asks us, ya Rabbi, we did. This is an excuse. Ma'adhiratan ila rabbikum. ولعلهم لعل الترجي might be they will fear Allah, but this never happened. And at least they did their job. سبحان الله. ففي حاجة يقول لك إيه, سبحان الله المعذر المعذر if somebody is coming with an excuse but he's a liar. والمعذر من يأتي بعذر صادق. Somebody he gets an excuse but he's honest. They said that in the meaning in Arabic. والموعظة they call it in English the admonition. If somebody is giving admonition regarding something everybody knows it, like حكم in the Quran, حكم in the deen, he's not coming something new. That's called موعظة. Sheikh give us موعظة. Like سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب, he used to sit a man, his name was كعب الأحبار. كعب الأحبار, he was a Jew and he became a Muslim. And كعب الأحبار, he was a rabbi, scholar. After he became a Muslim, سيدنا عمر said, عظني يا كعب الأحبار. Give me good admonition, يا كعب الأحبار. فكعب الأحبار, he used to advise عمر بن الخطاب, he used to give him. And the موعظة, the admonition, it is very short and very strong. Comes with nothing new, just the deen, the same rules. But the one who said it, he must be swift, strong. Yeah, short and strong. Let's call it موعظة. Mostly when people talk about death, the graves, the hereafter, you like عزني, you know? Like Harun al-Rashid, he used to sit a man, his name was Bahlul. And Harun al-Rashid in his palace. And they said, عزني يا Bahlul. Bahlul, he was a full man, يعني مسكين. يعني man, homeless, مسكين. But he's a good mu'min. And Bahlul, Harun al-Rashid, he's strong, strong Amir, يعني سبحان الله, Amir al-Mu'mineen, the leader of the Muslims. Strong. He used to talk to the cloud. He said, put your rain anywhere, in water anywhere, it's all coming back to us. SubhanAllah. Look how he was very strong, Harun al-Rashid. Strong, sitting in his palace. A lot of palaces. And he said, عظني يا بهلول. Give me admonition, يا بهلول. He said, يا Harun, these are their palaces and these are their graves. what kind of mawza you need? هذه قصورهم وتلك قبورهم. Don't think you're going to stay forever. You are in palaces, huh? The grave is waiting for you. That's it. This is short maw'iza, short cut. See? A man was very arrogant. And he was an emir, prince. Like this nowadays. A lot of guards around him. And he was passing by the masjid and a very pious man was sitting. I think he was Malik ibn Dinar, Allah a'lam. And everybody was running from the masjid, giving him way, except that pious man. He said, you don't know who am I? Why did not move from your spot? I'm the Amir. He said, I know you, of course. أولك نطفة مذرة. He said, what do you know about me? He said, أولك, first of you, نطفة مذرة. You are just a drop of semen, water. This is you. وآخرك جيفة قذرة. When you die, you're going to be filthy, rotten bones. وأنت بين هذه وذاك, you are in between, تحمل بين جانبيك العذرة. You are carrying bathroom in your stomach. This is you. What do you think, yeah? Why you are arrogant? Yeah, this is what he said. For this is this kind of موعظة. For these people, in Eilat or Eila, they told the people of the Sabbath, fear Allah, this is haram. Don't play with Allah's rules. And they did not listen. And they give them that an excuse. I said, this is excuse. And these people, they used to advise them all the time. That's why Allah said, فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ نَسُوا, يعني all the time they used to remind them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved those advisors, those who used to advise people, they've been saved. And second group, which is, they were quiet, Allah did not mention them. But Ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiallahu anhu, Akrima, and some of Fassirin, they have the fear between them. Some of them, they said, Allah destroyed them with those who used to disobey Allah. But Abdullah ibn Abbas said, no. They were quiet, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not mention them because they were quiet. سَكَتُوا فَسَكَتَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ. They were quiet, and Allah, he did not even mention them. But let's focus about these two groups. One group, those advisors, they said, stop, don't disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those who forgot the advice, those who disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلَمَّا عَتَوْا, يعني عَتَوْا, what's the عَتُوْ? العتو, when they became عَتِي, سَنْعَتِي, يعني إيه؟ يعني arrogant, متكبر, وإيه؟ disobedient in the same time. فَلَمَّا عَتَوْا, they were arrogant, they did not listen, and they disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What happened to them? فلما عتوا عما نهوا عنه, they did not listen, قلنا لهم, الله give order, be, what kind of order to them, كونوا قردة خاسئين, be monkeys and rejected, rejected monkeys, يعني even the monkeys, the real monkeys, when they see them say, hey, you're not good. Imagine that. Imagine that. They were human monkeys. طيب, they became monkeys in their action or physically they became monkeys. All the scholars, they said no. They became really monkeys. Some mufassirin, they said they became, their action became like monkeys. Some of mufassirin, they said more. Their oldest, or the oldest of them became khanazir. And another ayah said qiradatan wa khanazir. Khanazir like swan or khanazir. They said the oldest of them, they became khanazir. And the youngest, they became monkeys. That's why you think when they talk, they became monkeys. They act like monkeys like this. And the old ones of them, they act like khanazir. Subhanallah. But anyway, both or these people, old or young of them, those who disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the people of the Sabbath, Allah make them physically monkeys and khanazir. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Even one of them, he used to come to his relative, he's still human, and he became monkey. He used to talk to him, didn't I tell you? And they used to see the monkey crying. The monkey, human. He cried. He said, yes. Yani, he's regretting, but this is the power of regret now, but it's over. It's over. خلاص. يعني done. فالله سبحانه وتعالى يعني is telling us message here. Do not disobey Allah. Why Allah mentioned these stories to us in the Quran? Don't be like them. Like what I said. Those who are disobeying Allah, somehow Allah سبحانه وتعالى will open too many gates of punishment for them. Like I give example, like now somebody robbery. He's accepting rishwa under the table. Money. Haram. He became rich. But you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look at his life in reality. If you go into his life, oof, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his life is miserable. Allah is opening too many doors of problems for him. Sickness for him. Why? Because he did haram and he get this money from haram. He will never gonna enjoy it. Let this be. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it was a test for them. Well, Allah examined them too many times like that because they saw the miracles and they still disobeyed Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's why Allah described them. He said, فَلَمَّا عَتَوْا, they became disobedient and arrogant too. But that's why, humble yourself. Try to do good as much as you can. We are not angels. We are not 100%. يعني, Allah create us in a way we can disobey, we can come back. Allah, subhanAllah, create us in a way we have desires, shahwa, and everything. But Allah said even it's not haram to do that, but do it in the halal way. And you have something called the sabr, control. I give us the brain, وَلَقَدْ قَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. Allah honored you. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed you the manhaj. He sent you the Rasul. He gave you the Quran, the deen. And he gave you the brain, think and wisdom. And al-Iman, Allah, this is the best thing. It's a treasure, like what I said in the morning today. Al-Iman is the biggest treasure with you. Ya wallahi, subhanallah. For that's why you have all of this. And with that, shaitan also can deceive you somehow. That's why be in control. These people, they disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intentionally. They put the net evening, Friday, and they get it Sunday. Are you going to deceive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Already, you know, Allah is putting you in a test. And they were in big failure. That's why Allah make them qiradatan wa khanazir. Not all Bani Israel. We have to understand this. Because some people, they take al-hukm, kida khalas. All Yahudi, no. They were three groups. You have to be fair even when you judge between people. وَلَا يَجْرَ مِنَّكُمْ شَنْآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُ اعْدُلُهُ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَىٰ. When I talk to some sheikhs sometimes, said, no, لعنة, لعنة. I said, يا أخي لعنة. Abdullah ibn Salam, he was a Jew. He became a Muslim. كعب الأحضر. You cannot put all people in the same basket. No. And Allah said in the Quran, Surah Al-Imran, لَيْسُ سَوَاءَ. They are not equal, right? Some of them, they are mu'mineen. Some of them, they are good people. Some of them, when you talk about the deen and Allah Azza wa Jalla, like in Najashi, he was a Christian man. When Ja'far ibn Abu Talib, who was reciting Surah Maryam to him, tears comes out and he said, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. They are came from the same kuwa, same place, same source, the message of Muhammad and Isa. See? For that's why you cannot criticize everybody. You cannot say like that. Don't put them all in the same scale or same basket. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يهدينا وإياكم ويسوي السبيل. جزاكم الله خيرا.